and they are rolling out the red carpet and putting on a real aerial display for us. 8,000 quid with the fireworks. Literally, money going up in smoke, but it's nice to see, isn't it? Well then, while that's going on outside, going on inside. You know, a week ago, what a very different scene at the National Exhibition Centre in Birmingham. Eubank against Ben. Earlier today, I talked to Chris Eubank about that fight.
I knew I was going to beat Nigel Benn before I got in the ring. I've known it. I knew it the 6 weeks I was in intensive training before the fight. And I've known it for 2.5 years. I believed it, and that's what I had to prove. And from the bell rang, and he came, when I picked, I went towards him, and I fired that right hand, and I initiated that jab. And I was catching him with a very good, hard right, and right uppercut. I knew I was going to win. It was all going right for me. And Nigel gave me a lot of... gave me a lot to fight for, because I believed what he was speaking about was wrong. So I was fighting to tell the truth. I was fighting for truth. And so, in the future, if I come up against opponents who are speaking the truth also, then I suppose it won't mean as much to me. But I have every intention of keeping this world title and unifying it.
And the unification process starts right here, the Torre Quebrada Hotel and Casino on the Costa del Sol. Julian Jackson, one of the contenders, former world light middle champion, a man with only one professional career defeat. This man, one of the best punchers in the world, and he can bang a bit too, hence the nickname Bomber Graham. Second chance for a world title, and at the age of 31, possibly the last. Here he's training, and Eubank's trained with him too.
He's a brilliant boxer. He's a trickster. He's a stylist. He's a chess player. A chess player in the ring. He's a thinker. I believe he's going to have to be. He's going to have to want to punch tonight, because this Julian Jackson will be in front of him, and he's going to have to make him respect him.
I've heard that when you sparred with Graham, you knocked him down. Is that true?
In the first round, yeah. He outboxed me for one or two rounds. And then I caught him with a right hand, and I didn't knock him on his bottom, I knocked him on his back, that's how hard I hit him. And he got up and outboxed me for a 5 or 3 round.
You said you want to unify the middleweight title. If Graham wins, do you want to fight him?
Yeah, it's a possibility. According to Barry Hearn, it's a possibility.
No matter what Barry Hearn says, do you want to fight him?
Yes. I would fight. Herol Graham. If the business side of it is correct, and he has that WBC world title, then yes, it has to be, you know.
Well, has to be. You may have read otherwise in your papers, but this man will be in the frame. Herol Graham, boxing for the world title the second time. Lost last time for the world title to Mike McCallum, but that is no disgrace. Sambu Kalembe, the other man to beat him, that was for the European title. Kalembe went on to the world title. Julian Jackson's been a world champion before, of course, and this man is one of the best single punchers in the business. Just two fights of his have gone the full distance, the last of them 8 years ago. This man is formidable.
Ladies and gentlemen, doing a wonderful job.
And there is the WBO middleweight champion. Well, you may have read in your papers in England this morning, but Nigel Benn was back in the frame. But don't jump to too many conclusions, because if Bomber Graham wins this tonight, the prospect of unifying WBC and WBO titles for Chris Eubank could be overwhelming. The ring clear now. And Herol Graham and Julian Jackson getting into the ring in just a moment. Jim, your thoughts on the fight we're about to see?
As always, a fight at this level, it's very difficult to pick a winner. Obviously, my heart tells me I won with Graham. I'm excited about the prospect. You know, Errol's a tremendously elusive fighter, very, very awkward and difficult to hit against the explosive punching Julian Jackson. This is Nigel Benn and Chris Eubank all over again. Who's going to be Eubank at the end of the night?
Well, you never know. This will almost inevitably be Herol Graham's last crack at a world title. 31 years of age. Funnily enough, he's almost exactly a year older to the day than Julian Jackson. And here comes the challenger for the vacant title now. The title stripped from Graham for failing to meet Bomber Graham. Who could blame him? Not a bad guard of honour, Johnny Nelson, accompanying him into the ring. Cruiserweight champ.
Dave, it's funny how things turn around. I remember you sitting with Errol Bomber Graham this time last year to watch me challenge Zuma Nelson when Errol was commentating on my fight. So I'd like to wish Errol Bomber Graham, all the viewers and screen sport, all the best to become champion of the world. Good luck, Errol.
So that's seconded from me, and I'm sure all of you at home. Bomber Graham in the ring right now. Brendan Ingle, his guide and mentor for so long. The referee, incidentally, comes from New Jersey, Joe Cortez, very, very experienced referee, the American boy.
Now, this is a nice little touch, Dave, where they've all climbed through the ropes together, all seen a lot of familiar faces, like all the guys from his gym, Johnny Nelson inclusive, young Nassim, who's a good little player in his own right, and I'm sure this is, Errol feels very much at home at this moment in time, in the strange surroundings for a world title fight.
Well, we await the arrival of the power puncher, Julian Jackson, a man who has won his last 33 fights inside the distance. Only Mike McCallum has beaten him. Mike McCallum, the body snatcher they call him, stopped him in two rounds. Herol Graham took him to a 12-round decision for the world title.
Errol looking very relaxed and fully tuned in, which is great to see. Full focus. He's complained in the past about having problems, mental problems, when he's gone into big fights, which he's come second best in. Tonight he says he's 100% on the boil. He looks it.
No excuses there can be tonight. He's having something like his 15th title bout tonight. And Julian Jackson, we get the word, says he's not going to come out of the dressing room until he's ready to come out of the dressing room. So, as far as he's concerned, Herol Graham can just sit there and stew in his own.
You know, Errol's one of the old school, he's stuck at it, he's persevered, he's been a good pro, he's had a lot of fights. Tonight it'd be just reward to see a worthy champion like Bomber Graham. But it's not going to be no easy task, you know, he's really up against a tough, tough, tough opponent. When the bell goes, the title's up for grabs.
Brendan Ingle looking as calm as Brendan ever does. And, well, gamesmanship by the American. Graham will have warmed up in his dressing room. It's quite warm here in the ring, so I don't think there's too much danger of him cooling down. He looks a little bit cheesed off, I can't say I blame him.
You know, Dave, the only opponent I believe they've got in common is the body snatcher, the great Mike McCallum, the
That's
WBA
right.
middleweight champion, who holds wins over both guys. But interestingly enough, in the McCallum contest with Julian Jackson, McCallum was in big trouble apparently at the end of the first round.
That's right.
He stopped himself and pulled it out in a war in Manto.
Here comes the former WBA light middleweight champion of the world, managed by Carl King, son of Don. The American Virgin Islands is where he comes from. So he gets two flags. Give you some idea of Julian Jackson's punching power. 33 fights since 1982 have ended inside the distance, and of all his wins, 21 have been by clean KO.
Say no more.
I won't, in case Errol can hear me. So now we have all the formalities. We had the national anthems while you were away in the break. So let's get the introductions now from our good friend Nat Basso.
Thank you. Gentlemen, please. My lords, ladies and gentlemen, Ballyhearn's Matchroom, in association with Jack Trickett, proudly presents the main event of the evening, sponsored by Stormsteam. A 12-round international middleweight contest of 3 minutes each round and 11 stone 6 for the vacant WBC Middleweight Championship of the World between and in addition to you, with a record of 42 contests, 41 wins, 40 by the KO, the WBA light middleweight champion of the world from the Virgin Island, USA, Julian Jackson. And in this corner, with a record of 45 contests, 43 wins, 26 by stoppages, the middleweight champion of Great Britain and the former middleweight champion of Europe from Sheffield in England, Herol.
There's the bomber. News of, incidentally, of Jackson's delay. He was locked in his bedroom doing his preparations and literally refused to open the door to finish. It's prerogative.
From California, USA, Rudy Ortega. From Mexico, Jose Gwen Guevara.
Now, we've got two American judges, Rudy Ortega and Tom Kaczmarek. A Mexican ref judge as well, Jose Juan Guerra. And an American ref, Joe Cortez. So a lot of American officials tonight, Jim, and we know they like aggression.
That's right. So one thing that was worrying me, Dave, as everyone I spoke to about the fight, is the fact that if he is the aggressor, Jackson, you know, in a close fight, that could swing in his favour. Let's hope not.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, due to the Spanish Federation,
this is a fight that
will have to be done again.
It's got all the ingredients of a classic. Two top craftsmen with loads of fights behind them have certainly thoroughly learned their craft.
Well, we have everything over again in Spanish now. And while we listen to that, Julian Jackson looks as though he's been carved out of mahogany, doesn't he? So we get all the introductions over again. This is extraordinary. A bizarre venue. And bizarre introductions. Brendan Ingle looks suitably bemused. Brendan Ingle laughing.
All this is unnecessary, really. The fighters are ready to go now. And this is just like a little bit draining, really. Depends on how the fighters handle it. But certainly these two are old pros, and I'm sure they've experienced similar things in the past. Probably not in such a big occasion, though.
I have to smile, Jim, because the Spanish version of Michael Buffer is about 3 foot tall and 3 foot wide.
That's right. Well, this is where it all begins now. The talking,
yeah,
the hype is all over.
This is for real now.
And this is two of the best fighters in the world to see who really is the best.
Joe Cortez is the ref. He's from New Jersey, as is Frank Sinatra. But Joe Cortez is going to do it his way tonight.
I remember Joe Cortez from refereeing my own fight in the Azuma Nelson fight. Very good referee. It'd be interesting to see. Jackson's a fast start, he's had a lot of early wins. Bomber needs to be right on the ball from the off. He knows it.
I've seen Julian Jackson. He was on the same bill as Bruno against Tyson, defending his title against Francisco de Jesus. KO'd him in eight.
Yeah, I remember watching old Bomber Graham in the ABA final in 1978. He's been at the game a long time.
And in case you've never seen Graham before, can't believe it, because he's been on television a lot. The man's a southpaw. And opening up. It's a good start by Graham. But, oh, he's got to be careful of Jackson. Jackson can take you out with one shot, just like snapping a twig.
Positive beginning from Bomber Graham. He really opened the fusillade of punches. A real good burst.
Possibly the best defensive boxer that Great Britain has ever produced. Now tonight must show that he can win a world title. We've said he's capable of it for so long. Tonight, in this Spanish ring, that's exactly what he has to do.
I don't know if Graham's ever met anyone of the punching power of Julian Jackson, but I'll bet Julian Jackson's never met anyone as unusual as Errol Bomber Graham.
I second that, James.
Is there all that wide stance, southpaw, leans back, very evasive, good reflexes. Everything a good orthodox fighter wishes to avoid.
Remember that Jackson's had this much publicised detached retina problem. We're assured it's completely cured now. It must be. He wouldn't be allowed to box in Spain otherwise. But if there is a question mark over his vision, that'll be ruthlessly exploited by Herol Graham.
I'm sure that's in the back of the bomber's mind as well. You know, he wants to go out there and unload everything. This is his possible last chance, as you were saying, Dave.
I've got to say, Jim, I have never seen Herol look in better shape than he is tonight.
He looks fantastic.
And that's of the silky defensive skills that I was telling you about. And a good round, a good opening round for Herol Graham. I can't call him the challenger. They're both challengers tonight. The title, of course, is vacant.
You know, he's gone out positive from the off. And it's been a good round for Obama Graham. Very good.
He's taking it, no problem. Out. And Jackson, in contrast, looks slow and ponderous and a good left. Bounces off Jackson's head.
Jackson, as we know, is a big puncher, but Herol isn't at the moment letting him get set. He's just firing all cylinders from round one. Great stuff.
Well, it's as confident and as positive a start from Graham as we could have wished. And make no mistake, these punches are getting through and they're hurting Jackson.
And remember, Bomber can bang as well. I remember him banging out a friend of mine called Jimmy Price very early in a fight. Now, Bomber's no mean puncher himself. Jackson certainly looks a little bit confused.
There came the right. A good round for Herol Graham. And I don't think there can be any doubt that he must have taken that on the scorecards of all three ringside officials.
There was an arrogance of Julian Jackson saying to his trainer when he came back to his corner, believe it or not, no problem. Well, you know, many others have found it a big problem, and I think it's going to be a problem for Julian Jackson tonight as well. Great round from Herol Graham.
Brendan Ingle has made Herol Graham split with him, kissed and made up again, and there's no doubting, Jim, that Herol Graham isn't a complete fighter unless Brendan Ingle's in the corner with him.
No, definitely. You know, they work well together as a team, and he's obviously got a lot of faith in Brendan Ingle. I know Brendan has in Herol, and it'd be great for the both of them if Herol could pull it off tonight. It'd be a complete turnaround on the merry-go-round. But judging by the opening round, that was great stuff. Still needs to be careful because he's big punching Julian Jackson. It's like unnecessary risk.
Schedule for 12. Jackson in the yellow. Graham in the multicoloured trunks.
There's the vaulted right hand of Jackson.
Good left right on the button.
The eye's gone.
And Jackson is hurt and through the ropes almost and in desperate trouble. The former light middle champion, his vision is affected.
I think his left eye's closed, I'm sure it has.
He's unhappy about something. And the Jackson corner, just a yard away from us, are looking desperately apprehensive.
Bomber as cool as ever. Good concentration.
Now Graham has got to be cool. Something is definitely wrong with Jackson's left eye.
Yes, definitely.
He can't see out of it.
He's been caught, I don't know if it was...
Jackson cannot see out of his left eye. Is it too premature? I wanted to talk about having two world middleweight champions. Graham has made a wonderful start.
Absolutely. At the moment, Julian Jackson's pressed the panic button. He really is panicking, and rightly so.
Jackson's left eye is cruelly swollen and he can't see. He cannot see out of that left eye. And he's an open target for Graham. He's got no answer to the big Graham right hands.
And Bomber's the first to realise it. You know, he's noticed straight away that Jackson's rattled and Bomber's trying to capitalise right now.
Well, there's no place for sentiment in the boxing ring. Graham will see that injury and he will try and capitalise on it and use that to plot Jackson's downfall.
He's got to pump that jab on Bomber. He's right made for the right jab.
Jackson can't go on, surely. He's grimacing in pain, the American.
The eyes closed.
Graham fighting a one-eyed fighter at the moment.
Jackson's gone southward to try and enable his calls to become a little bit easier, but he's in big trouble.
Brendan Ingle telling Graham just to poke the jab out, poke the jab out. Graham's taking this round too.
Yes, in big style.
It was a right hand that closed Julian Jackson's left eye. No suspicion at all of heads. It was a punch that did the damage. We'll see that punch again in the break.
Testimony to the talent of Jackson. He switched to the southpaw stance to enable him to get some vision.
Another good round for Graham. Desperate for Jackson. We'll take a break.
According to the law of averages, one day soon, all cars will be equal. Is it not true, however, that one car will always be more equal than others? The new Ford Escort breaks the law of averages.
Well, that's the problem that Jackson has with his left eye. It was done with a right hand at the very start of round two. And I don't think the corner have been able to do too much about it. And desperation stakes, believe me, in the Julian Jackson corner, urging the man to go out and finish this. And as Jim's pointed out, he's fighting southpaw now, which is not his natural style.
Bomber looks very, very sharp.
And Graham, we know that he can dodge Jackson throwing the bombs, but Graham avoiding them.
As he's been doing so for many years, you know, this is Graham's art, up on the bike, sharp boxing. I'm sure he may have even received instructions from Brendan Ingle to go out and not get sloppy, keep it together. Be the artful dodger.
Remember that Jackson has only been beaten once in his career. Mike McCallum in two rounds. Perhaps, I wonder, is it too much to hope that he's on the brink of defeat number two tonight at the hands of the British number one middleweight, along with Chris Eubank, Herol Graham.
Yeah, Graham couldn't have made a better start. He's took one on the button there.
He hasn't got a bad chin, Herol Graham. Never been stopped, of course.
Someone once asked me what Errol's chin was like. I said, no one knows, he could never get it.
The American's corner, trying to urge him on, be first, be first. Oh, good shot from Graham. Yeah. I'm trying to pour it on. And once again, the American's eye looks a sorry, swollen state.
Yeah, he's in big trouble against a man of the class of Errol Graham. And only the third round of a 12-round world title fight.
Because, of course, if the left eye is closed, you can't see the right-hand punches coming, and that is just a bit of a handicap.
Slightly. Errol's gone orthodox now, would you believe it?
And at times he's making Jackson look so ponderous.
Good shot from Palmer again. Great concentration from both fighters.
Graham boxing orthodox again, or boxing southpaw again, I should say. Jackson forced to adopt a southpaw stance. Oh, good left.
Cracking right, left cross from Errol Graham.
And a good right.
He's beginning to unroll, he's beginning to unfold and beginning to look like a champion. Oh, I'm not saying that too prematurely. I know he's in the dangerous big puncher. He's getting a little bit desperate as early as the third round.
Well, this is the Herol Graham that we've always dreamed about seeing in a world title fight. He's boxing with such skill and poise and confidence, and I've given him, and I'm sure that I'm not biased when I say so, I've given him all three completed rounds so far.
Absolutely.
Well, there's the scenes in the American's corner, and the cold steel, and that is to reduce the swelling. You can see how bad that eye is. And the ringside doctor coming up to have a look now.
Yeah, he's in big trouble. You know, as we're in Spain, we call it desperado stakes, but he really is. He come back to the corner there and he looks very, very concerned.
Yeah, there is the ringside doctor. We're looking at Herol Graham at the moment, but above us, in the American's corner, Joe Cortez, the referee, is there too. And it's taking a very, very long look at Jackson. Are they going to let him continue?
He's getting plenty of attention in the corner.
They're letting him come out. I think the doctor says maybe just give him one more round or something.
He could well be.
That's the position. And Jackson looking grim-faced. The chance of becoming world middleweight title remote. And if this is, if his time is numbered, he will give it everything. And that's what I think what he's going to try and do. Graham wrestles into the canvas. No knockdown, says Joe Cortez. Graham says, you want to mix it? We'll mix it. Nice touch.
Even as he touched bomber was on his back foot. I tell you,
even a world title fight, still have time for sportsmanship like that. That's wonderful to see. Jackson, I think, realises that he isn't going to be allowed to continue for too long.
No, he's going for the one shot. And you know he's got the power and he's capable.
He can take Graham with one shot. So he's under no illusion about that.
Bomber needs to keep his wits about him here like he never has done before, because this man knows he can't go 12 rounds the way that injury is now. He's going to be looking to end it here and there.
Jackson's woes started in round two. A big right from Graham. The eye was gone. That, I think, the eye that he's had the detached retina problems with. Looking desperately for the big one-punch finish, Jackson, but can't find it.
There's not a worse opponent I could predict to have in front of him trying to put a one-punch knockout on Herol Graham. And this man is elusiveness like you've never known. Absolutely fantastic defensive boxer. From the days when he used to go in pubs and tie his hands behind his back and let would-be pub guys try and take him out. They couldn't do it.
Another good round for Graham. American's corner waving him on, trying to get him off the ropes, but Jackson has so little in comparison to Graham tonight.
Jackson, to his credit, sticking to his task, as desperate as it is.
But falling ever further behind him. Oh no! That's what we were worried about. He won't get up from that.
He's out.
A right hand. It's all over.
He's out.
Oh, would you believe it?
Unbelievable.
Would you believe it? And he's still out.
When you can punch like that, Dave, what can you say?
That is such cruel misfortune, but Julian Jackson, what can you say?
The biggest shot I've ever seen, and I've seen boxing over the years, but I've never seen anything like that. Graham was so in control. That's a real tragedy.
Jackson, you never know, this might have been the last round that he would have been allowed out for, Jim.
I think it probably was. It goes back to what we were saying earlier, that Herol had to be his most elusive at that moment in time, and Jackson was going to be desperate. He knew he couldn't go to 12 rounds, and he was just going to gamble all on the knockout, and that's what's happened.
And Herol Graham, I'm afraid, still out on the canvas. Well, these are scenes that have become distressingly familiar in world title fights that we've seen. But that was the most, I have to say, Jim, that was the most devastating one-punch finish I have ever seen in my life. We're going to see it again. Here it comes. Graham on the attack. Oh, look! And he was out before he hit the floor.
Gee, that was one hell of a shot. Dave, I never knew it was like that when he got connected. You know, Bomber Graham's got a... Bang, there you go. When a man punches like Jackson, I don't know what to say. I just really feel for him. I just don't let his moment and time that he's going to come round and be finding himself.
Well, poor Herol Graham is still unconscious on the canvas.
I could cry for the man. I really could cry for Herol Graham right now.
Well, to have a world title literally just seconds away, and he's coming to now, thankfully. Julian Jackson, the eye completely closed now. Well, you've got to give the man credit. He had one chance, Jim, and he took it.
Absolutely, you know, from Jackson's point of view, what can you say? The man's a great fighter. The guy had one eye. He'd lost every round up to the closing moment. And a lot of fighters would have thrown a towel in on themselves, but Julian Jackson's desperately, at the end of the day, has enabled him to win a world championship. Errol is really concussed at the moment, and I just hope he's going to be okay.
Well, the officials clustered around him. Chris Eubank looking very concerned there in the ring.
A lot of people crowding around Herol Graham, and really at this moment in time he needs a little bit of space. I'm sure he's going to be okay. I pray to the Lord that everything will be fine.
Well, my view is no better than yours at home at this moment. Herol Graham still on the canvas in the middle of that huddle of officials, doctors. They're unlacing his gloves at the moment. And I have a feeling they've called for a stretcher. An announcement went out of the ring in Spanish. And I think Graham is conscious, but just very, very, very concussed.
Speaking from experience of being in that position, they do keep you down in that position at all times. So, you know, that looks very desperate at the moment. I'm sure the doctor's got everything under control. Brendan Ingalls going through the routine, they've taken the gloves off on that. But
yes, Herol is conscious. When the gloves came off, I could see him clench and unclench his fists. He has recovered consciousness. He has recovered consciousness. He's sitting up now.
Well done, Herol.
And your heart just bleeds for this man. His dreams shattered literally with one punch. But what a punch. And you must give credit to Julian Jackson, who fought like a champion. From the very brink of the abyss of defeat, he came back.
That's why they say, Dave, that boxing is, without no shadow of a doubt, the hardest, most ruthless business in the world. You know, there's a man who could have been world champion, and now, what can one say?
Well, he's sitting on the stool now in the centre of the ring, and there's Julian Jackson. And the ironic thing is that Jim and I are as sure as one can possibly be that the referee was going to follow the doctor's advice and stop it at the end of the fourth round.
Errol was so close to being world champion, even his own eyes. He thought they'd stopped it at one stage and put his hands up.
In 1:13 of the fourth round.
Exactly midway through that fateful fourth round.
Julian Jackson.
What a puncher.
Well, with the good news that Herol Graham is back, albeit shakily, on his feet.
And ladies and gentlemen,
a good moment to take a short break. We'll be right back, though, at the Torre Quebrada here in Benalmadena on the Costa del Sol.
In a world where so many people are slaves to fashion, some still tread their own path. In a world where comfort is so often sacrificed to style, some people insist on both. In a world of hatchbacks and fastbacks, some people want a car in a class of its own. The new Ford Orion, a modern classic.
Replacement windows as unique as you are. Storm Seal. Why settle for anything less?
There are two ways to settle scores. There's the gentle art of discussion. And there's Boxing Weekly. Boxing Weekly. Your good clout every week.
My brother and I are identical in every way. Except you can take me anywhere.
Replacement windows as unique as you are. Storm Seal. Why settle for anything less?
It's 11 years since Ford won the RAC Rally. Way back in 79, Hannu Mikkola gave the Escort the last of its eight successive wins. Now, with the Cosworth 4x4, Ford could win again with Malcolm Wilson at the wheel. Lancia, Toyota, Mazda and Subaru will be there to stop him. And you'll be there with us. Daily reports start tonight at 11 on Screen Sport. More sport, more choice.
You're watching Screen Sport, a member of the ever-expanding European Sports Network, broadcasting via cable and satellite throughout Europe and the UK, 18 hours a day during the week and around the clock at weekends. For football with more flair, for motorsport with more grunt, for boxing with more punch, for golf with more drive, and constant action as it happens, wherever it happens. We're cracking the whip with sport satellite by satellite. Screen Sport, more sport, more choice.
Dramatic moment that Herol Graham's world title ambitions ended. I'm glad to tell you that he was able to leave the ring unaided, but Jim, having seen your own title challenge against Azuma Nelson end in similar fashion, you must know exactly how Herol feels right now.
Yeah, you know, words won't be able to commiserate him. As a saying I've said to a lot of fighters, when you lose, Dave, you know, tonight everyone's choked for Herol Graham, his family, the people in the ring, his trainer, but when you lose, mate, you lose on your own. And they will realise that in about 2-3 weeks' time, because that defeat will never leave his system. It will always be there, possibly for the rest of his life.
Well, we're going to show you a fight that took place earlier now between Slugger O'Toole and Johnny Melfer. It's scheduled for 8 rounds, O'Toole in the striped trunks, Melfer in the white, and we pick it up at the...